Do me a favor. Go to your TV, flip through your stations for, say, about 20 channels. Then ask yourself, how many people of color did I see? February is Black History Month, a month long of celebrating the African and Black American culture spanning centuries into the history of the United States, culminating in the achievements of Black people. Now, while most of you guys have been learning, hopefully learning in school about Black history, now, there's no way anybody can possibly contain all of Black history in just 28 days, which is why I will be doing it all throughout the year. Did you hear me in the back? I will be doing it all throughout the year. Why, you ask? Because representation matters. For instance, did you know that not only did Harriet Tubman free over 300 enslaved Africans via the Underground Railroad, but also was the first woman ever to lead a Union army in the Comahee Ferry Raid, not losing one person, and later freeing 700 enslaved Africans. Top that, Liam Neeson. Or that Bugs Bunny actually spun off from tales of African folklore that were later taken by Joel Chandler Harris in the form of Uncle Remus stories of Br'er Rabbit. Or Brenda Banks, one of the first Black women animators in the industry. The Count of Monte Cristo and the Three Musketeers, both written by Black French writer Alexandre Dumas. There is power in our words, just as there is power in our joy. As is emphasized in the story I'm about to tell you right now, aptly named Joy, 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 the Anthem for Black Boys. Joy, 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 the Anthem for Black Boys, written by Nzinga-Christina Reid, illustrated by Howard Berry. I've got joy on the inside of me. I look in the mirror and like what I see. From my kinky hair to my nose, lips, and eyes. I am a king, though I'm small in size. Joy, joy, joy all over me. This Black boy's joy means I love me. I'll change the world with my own two hands. It's not too hard, I know I can. I'm so smart and capable too. Just unstoppable in all that I do. Joy, joy, joy all over me. This Black boy's joy, the world will see. I'll do my part to protect my brothers. I'll give respect to the fathers and mothers. Let's not forget the sisters, too. I'll show them love for all they do. Joy, joy, joy all over me. This Black boy's joy means unity. I may fall down when times get tough, but I am strong. I'll get back up. You can't stop me, so don't you try. Strength of my ancestors by my side. Joy, joy, joy all over me. This Black boy's joy means let me be. I am powerful in all that I do. I'll speak my goals and watch them come true. And when in doubt or even afraid, I'll think of this anthem. And here's what I'll say. Joy, joy, joy all over me. This Black boy's joy means I love me. This Black boy's joy, the world will see. This Black boy's joy means I am free.
I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal. have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day, down in Alabama, with its vicious racists, with its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, one day right there in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
History, despite its wrenching pain, cannot be unlived, but if faced with courage, need not be lived again. Lift up your eyes upon this day breaking for you. Give birth again to the dream. Women, children, men, take it into the palms of your hands. Mold it into the shape of your most private need. Sculpt it into the image of your most public self. Lift up your hearts. Each new hour holds new chances for new beginnings. Do not be wedded forever to fear, yoked eternally to brutishness. The horizon leans forward, offering you space to place new steps of change. Here, on the pulse of this fine day, you may have the courage to look up and out and upon me, the rock, the river, the tree, your country.
If we merge mercy with might and might with right, then love becomes our legacy and change our children's birthright. So let us leave behind a country better than the one we were left. With every breath from my bronze-pounded chest, we will raise this wounded world into a wondrous one. We will rise from the gold-limbed hills of the West. We will rise from the wind-swept Northeast where our forefathers first realized revolution. We will rise from the lake-rimmed cities of the Midwestern states. We will rise from the sun-baked South. We will rebuild, reconcile, and recover in every known nook of our nation, in every corner called our country. Our people, diverse and beautiful, will emerge battered and beautiful. When day comes, we step out of the shade, aflame and unafraid. The new dawn blooms as we free it. For there is always light if only we're brave enough to see it, if only we're brave enough to be it.
To the power of joy and the power of words, the power of our voice. You know, that speech, that wasn't that long ago. At the same time that Martin Luther King was giving that speech, Star Trek was a show. Scooby-Doo was a year out from being made. There was already color TV. And we weren't that far from having a desktop computer. This wasn't all that long ago. Ruby Bridges was 6 years old when she first went through segregation. That wasn't hundreds of years ago. That wasn't over a century ago. That was actually not that long ago at all. So while some may be caught up in differences in skin color, you don't have to be one of them. Celebrate the skin you're in. Because if you take a better look at it, you'll notice it's not just brown. It has the red of the sand of Africa, flints of gold from Ghana and the Sudan, flecks of starlight from the sun, beautiful reflections of the Most High. You know, once upon a time, people of color weren't shown in such a good light, even in old cartoons and movies. Sometimes it was really insensitive, and other times downright hurtful and cruel. But just remember, if you ever come across any of those images, it's less of a reflection of the people that they were representing, and a stronger reflection of the ignorance of the people who made those images. There's an old saying, and it goes like this: be the change that you wish to see in the world. That means when you see something you don't like, do something about it. Now, while that can all apply to just about anything but the weather, that also means standing up for what you feel is right. And that also includes when you see someone at school being picked on or telling a librarian you want to see more books with people from other communities. Now, back in my day, long before the days of GIFs and Hulu, thanks to Lisa Galopter, long before the days of Super Soakers, and thank you, Lonnie Johnson, long before the days of the fedora when Story J was just a little J, I didn't always see books with kids that looked like me. I'm gonna tell you a little secret. Kindness is a superpower, one of the few resources we still need more of. And I met one such author who is being the change by writing books like the one I just read earlier. And here she is, all the way from the East Coast, New York, New York. Say hello to author of Joy, 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 Nzinga-Christina Reid. Hello, Nzinga, and how are you doing today?
I'm great, Story J. Thank you.
Awesome. Glad to hear it. Tell me a little more about yourself.
I am a licensed social worker here in New York State. And part of what I do is I have a nonprofit called Black Diaries, which shares the narratives of people of color. And so my whole life is dedicated to sharing Black stories and creating stories that I want to empower children. That's what I do.
Now, can you tell me a little bit about your book?
Sure. The book is called Joy, 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 The Anthem for Black Boys. And it's written by me and illustrated by Howard Berry, who is an illustrator based out of St. Louis.
You explore the true power of joy in this book. How did you come into this theme?
So I guess how I came into this theme was after giving birth to my son, who just turned 4 the other day. When I was on maternity leave with him, I started really just practicing my writing. And this particular book dropped in my spirit. I just was laying in bed early in the morning and I kept hearing over and over, "I've got joy on the inside of me." And I just kept saying it over and over. And each time I said it, I would add on a line. And it really just was me thinking about what I wanted him to feel. You know, what type of environment I wanted him to have and what I wanted to implant in him, which was just Black boy joy.
That is amazing. I love that. I mean, I wish I had more of that, like growing up too, because I think every Black boy deserves that. Every Black child deserves that. Every child in general deserves that. So what you're doing with this is phenomenal. So I just wanted to say that. Thank you very much for that. So first and foremost, who were your inspirations in doing this?
My inspirations are Malcolm X and Angela Davis. And, you know, just really drawing from the generation ahead of me that was revolutionary, forward-thinking, Marcus Garvey, you know, that just really wanted to change the narrative of Black people and wanted to empower us and cause us to push back against systems of oppression.
I love that. I just started reading The Fire Next Time from James Baldwin. Yeah, and because, you know, when we had Black History Month, it was like Martin Luther King, Malcolm X, you guys are done.
Rosa Parks, right.
Yeah, and Rosa Parks, and that's it, yeah. So what you're doing by exposing people to this, like, the basically being a child of the revolution and educating people outside of the culture of Black people and Black community is amazing. So once again, thank you very much for doing this. Thank you very much for being a part of this.
And on the one of the pages, actually, that says, "You can't stop me, so don't you try, strength of the ancestors by my side," Baldwin does appear, of course.
Yes.
He is definitely a leader in his own right.
Absolutely. I love that. What would you say to all the little girls out there, especially Black girls out there and all girls of color or kids of color? Do you have any advice or words of inspiration or words of wisdom you want to share with them?
I do. And that would be to tell your parents to buy my children's book called Joy, 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 The Anthem for Black Girls.
The best piece of advice I've ever. That's awesome.
Which is coming out next month for Women's History Month. We're releasing the girls' version of the book. But definitely just to, you know, that the theme for little Black girls is usually Black girl magic because we are magical. But, you know, I wanted to create a girl version of the book. I don't even want to call it a girl version of the book, but right. I want to create a book for girls, mm-hmm. you know, personifying joy, because that's so important. The same reason as the boys. There's so many things that will try to steal your joy mm-hmm. that, you know, us as parents really have to just focus on creating an environment that is joyous. And girls need to know that whatever color they are, however their hair is textured, they are beautiful,
yeah.
right? Yes. Daughters of the diaspora are beautiful. And that's mm-hmm. something that I want them to all to know, that we are intelligent, that we are capable, that we can achieve anything. Yes.
Absolutely. Love it. That was a perfect answer. Did you ever have any unexpected obstacles or any amazing parts that happened like during writing or drawing these?
So definitely being self-published was very difficult. I have a coloring book called Yoruba Mythology Coloring Book, The Gods and Goddesses of Yorubaland. And that I went with an individual who helped me throughout the self-publishing route, including finding an illustrator of color and really putting the book together for me. And so I modeled what she did for this last book, Joy, 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 the Anthem for Black Boys. And I was like, okay, let me see if I could do it myself. Yeah, I almost said, you know what, this is too much, forget it. It's not worth it. And that's how I know this book is so special, because I had to hold on to everything within my spirit. Like mm-hmm. I really just had to believe in what it is that I was doing, because I was about this close to saying, this is above my skill set and it's not even worth it. It's too rough. Much energy. So it was definitely difficult for me to learn how to like format and upload, and it just was a whole learning curve that I didn't want to repeat again. But then I said, the girls deserve a book. So, mm-hmm.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
So it was definitely hard being self-published, but I felt the message was important to push through it and get the content out for readers.
I can't tell you how much I appreciate your being here. Number one, I want to also reiterate that readers, she is in New York right now. There's a 3-hour difference between us talking right now. So it's early in the morning for me. She's doing like right at noon, and she also has to go. So thank you so much, Nzinga. I so appreciate this, and I'm sure my readers love this. And readers, go get her book. Please, go buy her book. That was just phenomenal. So thank you so much, Nzinga, for being here at Storytime today.
Thank you so much for having me. I appreciate it.
And by the sound of the... You know what? Can't we actually do something a little different this time? Just this once? Thank you. So before we go, I just want to say thank you guys once again for joining me for this celebration of Black history. Because whether you know it or not, you are going through history right now. And by doing the right thing, by being the change you wish to see in the world, you are making history. A chapter written just by you. While it is good to remember the trials and tribulations of the past, it's always best to keep in mind the dreams and joys of the present and future. So celebrate. Be joyful. Be a dreamer. Be the change. Be the fire. And be. Just be. And I'll see you next time.
Hey, fellow YouTubers, if you like what you see, please hit like and subscribe. And if you want to see more, just click on the button where you can donate and be a paying contributor, where you can see more things like read-alouds, drawing tutorials, virtual field trips, cartoons, and more. See more at StoryJStorytime, and I'll see you next time.